Number 10, if God's on earth, who runs the universe? This is a typical one that comes up all the time.
If you see that God came to earth, took on human form, while he was human, who is running the universe? And that's a good one. That's a good one, because you can see what they have done is that Muslims are confused in the way, and the, probably the problem is ourselves. We come across as saying that all of God is in Jesus Christ. And it's that, that phrase that Jesus is 100% God and 100% man that confuses them. We need to be careful that we define what we mean by 100%, 100%. We're not saying that all of God, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit is in Jesus Christ. Okay? But that's what they hear, which is a Sabellian heresy. The Sabellians believe that. Sabellius is the one that believed that when God came to earth, he was God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, all as God. And then, so therefore, he was God the Father, and then God the Son, all three persons were in the Trinity on earth. And then now he went back to heaven, so he's now God the Holy Spirit. It's like a three-act play almost. We're not saying that, and that, but the problem is that's what they're hearing. So I can understand the question. We need to be very clear that when God was on earth, that was a second person in the Trinity, God the Holy Spirit was still running the universe. God the Father was still in heaven. And that's why there's not a problem if you believe in a triune God that God would continue to do that. But then throw the question right back in their lap and say, okay, here in chapter 20 of the Quran, you have the story of Moses. He sees a fire in the distance. He goes to investigate the fire. As he gets close to the fire, a voice within the fire in verse 10 says, Moses, take off your shoes. You're on holy ground. So is that God in that bush? Well, if it's holy ground, by definition, it better be God, because how can you have any ground that's holy without God being there? By definition, if it's holy, God must be there. In verse 12, the voice then says in the bush, for truly it is Allah who is speaking to you. So therefore, that bush, that being, that fire that does never consumes it, that fire there is claiming to be God. Can anybody claim to be God but God himself? So ask your Muslim, is that God in that bush? And you can see the gears will start to turn in his head. He's in a dilemma here. You can see why. Because if he says, no, that isn't God, that's nothing more than emanation of God, then you might, then you're going to have to tear out that out of the Quran. You're going to have to tear that out of the Quran, because that says clearly that God is in that bush. You can see they borrowed the story from the Bible. When you borrow a story from the Bible, be careful, because when you borrow the story, you got to take the meaning with it. Because in the Bible, in Exodus 3, we know clearly that that was God in that bush. We don't have a difficulty with that. The Jews don't have a difficulty with that, because the Jews knew that God could come to earth anytime he wants. That was God who's walking and talking in the clear of the day. And Genesis chapter 3, that was God that was wrestling with Jacob. And that was God who was leading the children of Israel through the desert as a pillar of cloud during the day and a pillar of fire during the night. For the Jews, that was never a problem. It's not a problem for us. Our God can enter time and space anytime he wants. The Muslims have a problem. They can't believe this. So here you can ask them, hold on a minute. In chapter 20 of the Quran, it looks like God is on earth at that time. So while God was on earth in that bush, you have to admit that that was God who is running the universe. Ooh, then. Bingo, you've got the same question right back on their laps. See how they squirm. They don't know how to answer that. Be careful of the questions you throw, because remember that holy adage, he who lives in glass houses should not throw the first stone. All right? It's a dilemma for Islam. This is not a dilemma for us. This is only a dilemma for Islam. And that's why what the Muslim is asking, the very question they're asking, is really their question that they have to follow. Because this is only a problem for Islam, not a problem for us. Okay? Hope that helps.